Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a beautiful, serene day into an apocalyptic nuclear explosion. This is an update to a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. I provided this image for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Zoom out of your document by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key twice. Go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Go to the top ruler and drag out a guideline to the top of your document. It'll snap in place because we have snap checked. If you don't see it, press Ctrl or Command H. Go to the left ruler and drag out another guideline to the center. Open your transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Click the warp icon. By dragging the points and lines of the grid, you can drastically warp your image. In this example, go to the right top corner and drag it out to the edge of your canvas, flush with the guideline. Repeat this on the upper left corner. Press Ctrl or Command plus 1 to see your document at 100%. Go to this crosshair of the grid and drag it to the left approximately this much. Repeat this on the opposite crosshair, making sure that the end of the highway remains in the middle and the painted yellow lines are straight. Then, click the check mark or press Enter or Return. To hide the guidelines, press Ctrl or Command H. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, click this icon or press D on your keyboard. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make the brightness 75% and the lens type 50 to 300 mm zoom. Drag the lens flare to the center of the preview window. Then click OK. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 25 pixels and click OK. Make a copy of it and let's name it Road Flare. Click off the eyeball to temporarily hide the layer and click the thumbnail of the original lens flare to make it active. Open your transform tool and click the chain link icon to link the width and the height. Type in 300 in either the width or the height. Notice both are now 300%. Then click the check mark or press Enter or Return. Change the blend mode to hard light. Make the road flare layer visible and active. Change its blend mode to color dodge. Open your transform tool and for the height, type in 50%. Make sure the chain link is not highlighted. The width should remain at 100%. Then click the check mark. To move the road flare to the road, just drag it down. The next few steps will be to add multiple lens flares of various shapes to create the look of the explosion. Click the thumbnail of the large lens flare to make it active and make a copy of it. Drag it to the top of the layers panel. Open your transform tool and this time for the width type in 300 and for the height type in 60. Then click the check mark. If you want to nudge the lens flare, just drag it. Make a copy of the layer and open your transform tool. For the height, type in 50. Change its blend mode to color dodge. We're going to position the lens flares on the explosion as we create them. To prevent them from snapping into positions we don't want, go to View and click on Snap to disable it. Drag the lens flare straight up approximately this much. This makes the explosion look like it's expanding the higher in the sky it goes. Make a copy of the layer and open your transform tool. Make the height 10. Drag it to the middle of the horizon line, and to accept it, click the check mark or press enter or return. Make a copy of the layer and open your transform tool. Make the width 50 and the height 200. Then accept it. Drag the flare straight up to the top of the large explosion. Make a copy of the layer and just drag the copy straight up approximately this much. Make a copy of the layer and open your transform tool. Make the width 30 and the height 50. Then accept it. Drag it straight up approximately this much. The next few steps will be to add this hot yellow color to further enhance the fireball's intense heat. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer. Fill it with black and go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Change its blend mode to Overlay. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Gradient. The style is linear and the angle is 90 degrees. Click the gradient bar and click the black-white preset box. Click the lower left stop and the color box. Type in F9D300 and click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and this time type in 443B06. Click OK on all three windows. Go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. The gradient adjustment layer will slide to the right, indicating that it's being clipped to the one layer beneath it, which is the cloud layer. Lastly, we'll brighten just the dark areas of our image. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer. Make a composite snapshot by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. Make the shadows 35 or 40% and click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.